find entrance, they couldn't find entrance, they kept roaming, roaming around, until finally they found a crack, just a small crack enough for one person at a time to go through. And they said, we'll go through this crack. And that's how they came through the mountains up in the northeast. When they came out, they saw the land, Cassie Hills. It looked so nice, beautiful hills, rolling hills, beautiful streams. They said, we'll go here. But then they said, well, there are two of us, so why don't we separate? Let us not both go to the same place. One go west, one go east. And so they decided. And so the one who went west is a lady that we call Garo. And the one who goes east is the lady we call Cassie. Mm-hmm. And that's how the Cassie and Garo came. They grew closely related. But the Garos were not settled in the west. They met them. And the Cassies lived on the east. That is the legend, the story. We don't have written records, but that's how the story comes to us, how Cassie came as a part of the Monkmar movement in those long, long time ages. But most of the Monkmar went further east, but we came and settled down and found a place. And so they are related. Your cousins are Sigurd, Cassies and Garos. Really, everything. And we have more or less the same kind of idea about worship about this and that. But that is just part of the legends and the stories that we learn. Many have forgotten. I think most, if you ask them all the Cassie, many won't even know this story. Only the old one, all of folks will remember. Sometimes we just discard them because we think, oh, it may not be true. We don't know if it's true or not, but that is how the story comes down. A lot of legends that we learn about history itself are not something that we can find, you know, but it's really there. I was telling Coco about the garden nut. You know what the garden nut is? You don't. Okay, let me tell you. When Alexander the Great was on his way toward the east along the Mediterranean Sea, he came to a place where he found this big lump of rope that had become like a ball, you know, and he had put so on this the legend tells him, people around, they said, you know, it is said that whoever can unravel this knot, this big rope, whoever can unravel his way to the east is open. And Alexander was planning to go to the east. So he spent a few days there trying. He couldn't find the end. The ends are inside. And the rope had been there for who knows how long. Solid. But in frustration, finally, he took his sword and cut that rope in two, split. And he said, now my way to the east is open. And so he went east all the way to India, to the river Ganges. That's how the legend comes, the story. So we have in English now the Gordon Knot. Anytime you find something that is almost impossible, something that is too difficult, you cannot solve, that is known as the Gordon Knot. Can be solved in many ways. He solved it his way. He cut it into a length. Those are some of the stories we know, we learn from history and from others. But we learn how some of these sayings come to in the English language. So even in English, if somebody says, oh, I have a Gordon knot, I mean, I have a problem I can't solve, something like that.